Bienvenidos al Musing con Menchaca. Aquí estamos vivo en el Broken Bow, Oklahoma, con Luis Menchaca, el host, Juan Menchaca, el soldado, y el otro Juan Vergas, Vargas, el bien analítico, y yo, el papacito, chulito, Isai Toledo. Aquí te lo voy a tener a Luis Menchaca, se lo va a pasar a mi compa. ¿Qué dice, compadre?
Yeah, that's right. Hello, ladies and gentlemen of the internet. Welcome to the Musing with Menchaca show. This is the conversational podcast where four family members gather around these microphones, each with their own random topics of discussion to hash out for your amusement. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up, share us with your friends, and subscribe for more content. I am your host, Luis Menchaca, and joining me today, we got we got the soldier of fortune, Juan Jr., and next to him, the baby face, Isai. And rounding out the table, was it the grub fingers, right? What was it? Was that what it was?
Who knows?
Kind of Kuno, dude, like Kulo.
Juan Vargas, right over there. So, let's see. So, you can follow me on Twitter at Chocolaca88, PSN, Nintendo Network, XBL, and Twitch, all Chocolaca88, all across the board. Easy to remember. And you can also email me, boomchocolaca4@gmail.com, for anything long form you want addressed on the show, as well as the iTunes. Link is in the description. You can listen to the show, audio version, if you guys want to multitask. So let's go ahead and get onto it. We don't have a lot of time. As you guys can tell over here, we're recording with background noise going on here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes. A lot of background noise.
Okay.
And so scattered around.
Yeah.
Too.
So we're here in vacationing. We're here vacationing here in a cabin in the woods. If you guys are following me on Twitter, you guys will already be well aware of that. But so we're here just going to chill. We're going to just have a little conversation. We're not going to try to keep it too long, but who knows what we're going to be doing topics or not. But I got a topic. So my topic is favorite family vacations. What do you got?
You know,
favorite stories, funny stories.
My favorite family vacation since, you know, I'm have a family of my own now. You know?
Okay. All right.
Of three, a family of three. Thank you. We went to San Antonio. No, actually, we went to New Braunfels, Texas. Had a little road trip just about a month ago.
Uh-huh.
We went to New Braunfels to Schlitterbahn to go and for a birthday party. And, man, we get there. We're like, oh, man, the water's going to be so freaking hot. And it's going to be all muggy because a lot of people were there and yada, yada, yada. Man, we try to jump in there, man, and next thing you know, the water's freezing like no other, dude. Like, it was Antarctic weather type.
Okay.
And my balls shriveled up so much. They look like raisins. But now we went there. Then from there, we went to San Antonio. You know, went to SeaWorld. And it was my first time there, too. So that was a good experience for me. And then after SeaWorld in San Antonio, of course, everybody knows, obviously, you have to do the river walk.
Uh-huh.
You have to have some Mexican food. And then from there, we went to South Padre. And it was just me and my daughter and Vanessa. We went out there and enjoyed our time, man. You know, it was a little road trip we took for a week, and we really enjoyed it. My favorite family vacation.
It was just the three of you?
Just the three. Just the three of us.
All right.
Hey, make a sign, girl. Make a sign.
My girlfriend's back there doing
this to me.
So your voice can sound a little bit more sexier.
All right.
There you go.
Yeah.
Raisin nuts. Raisin nuts?
Raisin nuts, dude. Yeah, they got so tiny. And you know how turtles stick their head out, and then when they get scared or something startles them, it's a little something like a shock, they come back into their shell. That's how my penis was, dog. It just went right back in.
So for me, besides the conventions, which I'm not even going to get into because I dedicated a whole topic on the last podcast with the conventions, but Beyond that, I would say a family vacation for me would be like the cruise. It was really awesome. Yeah, we went on the cruise. Was it? We did the dirt bike, or not dirt bike, ATV.
Yeah. Oh,
we
nice.
Did the ATV,
through the caves and stuff.
Where'd you go? Caves.
What cruise?
Carnival cruise. We did the. It was just yeah.
Cozumel.
Oh yeah, Cozumel. Yeah, how that's right. That awesome. We saw the pyramids.
We're thinking about planning. Oh, so awesome. You go out there, man.
Yeah.
We did ATVs around the island. And we went through caves. Awesome, man.
Yeah,
yeah. We saw the dolphins in the distance.
You know what? We took a boat ride in South Padre, dolphin watching boat ride.
Yeah.
And we saw like a handful of dolphins. They're pretty custom pictures. Yeah, I can you know, send it to you. You can put it like right here somewhere.
Yeah, right. Or
anywhere yeah. in between. You
Make
know.
Sure to send it to me. Otherwise, I can't put it up.
Yeah. I got you. I got you. And it'll bring you know animal dolphin lovers to your podcast. And
Peter will love that.
Yeah, Peter will love it, dude. Yeah, you're pro animal.
That's right.
Except whenever it's time for hunting.
That's right. We did the trip where we were all camping and stuff. The camping trips. Those are good ones. We went like in November for my birthday. I forgot it was like my 23rd birthday, or something like that. I was holding the shotgun and everything.
Oh yeah, awesome. Yeah, yeah. Mm.
Yeah.
So my turn.
Yeah, go for it.
All right. So there's just so many to pick from. I mean, you say favorite vacations. I've gone to Mexico a few times.
I mean, shoot, we're all Mexican.
We've all been to Mexico.
those are vacations, you know.
Yeah, vacations. Well, I mean, like, here's the thing. Here's the thing, though. Before you go into your thing, so like the thing about I wanted from this topic is like I feel like there's always those funny stories that you know that you don't tell. Like they're like so just today, like earlier today when we were vacationing, we were on the canoe and my dad just tipped over and his phone was in his pocket. God bless that iPhone. It's dead. Just got a.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that phone's dead.
Died.
It's dead. I can get it fixed, man. Right. I have a friend who can fix it, really.
Right. Well, I mean.
He fixed my phone. I had a Sony Xperia and it's supposedly was waterproof, but only for like a few amount of time.
Yeah.
And I was in a jacuzzi for about 5 to 7 minutes, dude, and until I realized that the phone was in my pocket. Holy
cow.
Oh, my
God.
And it was completely dead. It didn't work whatsoever. Yeah. I put a dryer on it, put it in rice, did everything I could, and still
dryer,
nothing.
Man, that's a microwave. Man, damn.
And, dude, next thing you know, I just call my buddy, Caesar, and I'm like, hey, dude, my phone fell in the water, man. Is there anything you can do? Yeah, man, I'll see what I can do. Just bring it up here and, you know, to my shop and... And I'll see if I can get it working for you.
Yeah.
I went to his shop, dude, and he does it for a living. You know, that's what he does. Fixes phones, you know, electronics, tablets, iPhones, any kind of phone you can think of. And he took it apart. He dried everything, dude. He dried the little lenses that are there. And, man, after that, after he serviced it and, you know, dried it, it turned right on, man. And it worked perfectly fine. Yep.
What?
Yeah.
And then thank you very much to our sponsor. It's like this is all like advertisements, all it is.
That's free advertisement
for your friend.
There you go. No, but yeah.
So, yeah, you know. So digressing from your story to my dad's story, and then back to me.
Right. right.
I think I have to say the cruise was up there. It's like way up there.
Right.
But my Disney vacation with my girls a couple years ago was probably way up there.
Was this around the time, Disney already buy out Marvel?
Yeah. I don't know if they bought out Marvel, but they already had Star Wars.
Okay, they already. No, Disney they bought out Marvel first, then they bought out Star Wars.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Must mean Iron Man was there. Somebody must have been there.
All of the Star Wars stuff was there. A lot of stuff was there that I didn't even know that they owned.
Hey,
Disney owns everything.
Some of the rides for the Star Wars rides were awesome.
I didn't even know that Disney bought out Marvel.
Yeah.
You didn't know that?
Oh, I did not know that. Man.
Yeah.
Really?
It was like for $4 billion, I think.
Holy cow.
Yeah. Cool. Like literally, like no, like Disney pretty much owns everything. They own your childhood.
They own your networks, too.
They own your childhood.
They own your childhood, exactly.
So, yeah, I think I'm going to put Disney up there, for sure.
Yeah? Okay. Awesome. And then I remember you coming back.
A lot
back,
of memories.
You came back with those little, like.
So, I bought some little Mickey Mouse ears, except it was R2-D2.
So, that's right.
Yeah. With the ears.
It's so that's boyfriend can grab.
You send me a picture?
What? I still have them and everything, so what?
That was a gate comment, dude.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Can you send me a picture so that guy put on screen?
Sure.
All right, cool. Yeah.
You can, like, crop it out and put on his head out there.
Right there.
Yeah.
How about you, Juan?
I got a story. You know, growing up in Chicago, you know, or East Chicago, we had the biggest grass we seen was probably about this big, right? Yeah. So we go out camping. We go out camping with a couple friends. I took a couple guys from work and my cousin Ishmael, and we start going. So, you know, we're young, right? And probably in the same car that I was telling you the story about.
the same other car. Yeah. Different okay. story off camera.
Yeah, so, you know, we're smoking, right? And then we get down there. We're high as hell. It's night. We get there at nighttime, right? We set up our tent. So the tent is supposed to be a, you know, like a house tent, right? You got the small bar, the big bar in the middle, and the small bar on the side, right? So, you know, being the way we were, you know, we put up our tent. We go, we wake up in the morning. Sure enough, our tent, we put the small one, and then the big one, right? So our shit was like up like a ramp, right? And then we look around the campground, and everybody had the same damn tent, and ours was the only one that was all crooked. Right? it was stupid, dude. So we were there for like 2 nights. So we just said,
Oh my God.
We said, screw it. Let's leave it like that. So then, you know, never been fishing before. So, you know, we get in the canoes kind of like we were in the, today, and we start rowing, right? It was four of us. So we were in a canoe. The other guys were in a canoe. We start rowing. Man, we ain't going nowhere. It's like, God damn, there's a guy that was fishing on the edge. He goes, hey, why don't you put your anchors up? Yeah, he had two damn anchors on the damn, all right?
Oh anchors?
Oh, my God. Yeah.
Wow.
So we're, you know, there's like a little island and a little lake. And the guy tells us, hey, we tell the other guys, hey, we'll race you guys. They didn't know either that the anchors were down on their shit, right? So we're fucking smooth sailing, and they're pedaling their ass off, and they didn't realize they had their anchors out.
You were so wrong.
So
you should have bet some money on that race.
Yeah, yeah. I was going to say. I was like, I'll race you $5, man. Let's go. Come on.
And then just real quick, we're fishing, right? So I guess the worms, the point is to keep the worm alive it's on the hook. Well, we fucking try to hook that shit on there. You know, never done this shit before. We try to hook it on. The worm will go to the other side. You know, it just kept squirming and shit. So we just throw them on the boat, on the canoe, just slam them, knock them out, and then fucking tie them up to the hook. And then fucking,
you know, they'll still alive if you just kind of sort of, you know, hook them on.
Just a little bit.
They'll still stay alive.
Yeah. Sometimes you do it twice. You go, like,
yeah, some people like twirl them, cook it, twirl it.
Well, what you can do, too, is like, you know, a worm is like this. Put it in the butt.
Oh, I've seen him put it in the butt
of the worm and just go all the way in, guide it, and then just start turning it. So that way they're hanging, your hook's like this, and they're just hanging. Mm-hmm.
I've seen people do that, too.
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
That's what I do.
That's,
sometimes when I go fishing.
Like, he knows that now. Because
He's been fishing.
But now that I think about it, it feels like every vacation story that has any kind of comedy to it, it always involves my dad. Like always,
your dad. Is
like,
always
he's always got the stories where it's like him with the kayaking. Was it the kayaking? Or
It was the canoe.
No, it was not, but the air gliding. Didn't they do air gliding?
We did air gliding. Yeah, on our last one.
And they like he was like so scared or something like that.
I mean he was okay.
Yeah. Or his mom or someone was freaking out. But I remember it was these stories where it's like it always involves him. And then there was that one infamous story where we were climbing a mountain. And then dad had to stop.
He had to stop and take a crap.
What?
And then I think it was my mom.
My mom took the camcorder.
She took the camcorder and was recording.
Where was this at?
This was in Durango.
Oh.
We were stopping by the
Cerro.
Yeah.
Dang.
And then he was all like that. And then my mom was just like,
what's going on?
And he's all bent down. My dad's all squatting. And
your mom was like Izel on Friday.
Yeah.
Hey. Smoking back here, taking a shit.
Yeah.
That's funny, dude.
I had a, talking about shit, we went to Mexico, too. I went and climbing a mountain with my cousins, right? And I go up there, and I had to take a shit. And I didn't have nothing to wipe my ass. So I had a white T-shirt underneath, right? So I take my shirt off, I wipe my ass, and I leave the shirt there, right? You know, so come down the mountain. I get back from Mexico. I tell my cousin, hey, this is what happened. We were talking about it. And I took a shit. I didn't have nothing to wipe my ass. I left my shirt there. He went like a year later. He went up the mountain and he found my fucking shirt. He came back. He's like, I found your fucking shirt. I was like,
lo quieres, güey? Te lo lavo y te lo mando, güey.
Shit.
God damn.
Wow.
That's awesome.
That's good. Man. All right. Well, that was a good topic. That was pretty good.
I sharted one time.
At the lake. Yeah.
Sharded?
Yeah, I was at the lake.
The lake?
I was at the lake, dude, and I thought it was a little fart, you know? Just I don't mean nothing. I went. And, dude, oh, my gosh. I just stood up real quick. I was like, because shit came out. I was like,
dude, this happens to all of us. It hasn't happened to me, but, you know, it happens to all of us.
I've never shuddered in my life, dude. And I didn't even know what it was like. But all I remember was this wet, hot feeling down there. And
dude, you're making me horny.
That's the point.
Like, wait, what?
It was
luckily every time I've ever sharted before, it was always in the house, my house, and so I just went straight running to the toilet after.
That's kind of bad whenever you hit the shart in your house and the toilet's right around the corner.
No, yeah, that's the thing. It's good because then you can just like throw away the underwear. Like,
well, hold on. So this happened to me like less than a year ago, and I think it was just I attribute it to being old. You know, I woke up as normal. I'm literally walking to my toilet to take my morning piss, and I just like, you know, I want to rip some ass. And I ripped some ass and crap fell out in my butthole. And I was like, what? And I was literally 4 feet from the toilet, you know? And I was like, what? And then I looked, and sure enough, there was a shit running down my leg and laying on the ground. Oh. I was like, what the hell? And
That's crazy.
I was like, what did that happen? I said, how'd that happen? That was kind of embarrassed. I don't even know why I'm telling you guys, but it was embarrassing. And I just wiped it all up, and the bathroom smelled like shit for like ever.
That must have been pretty bad.
But those
Menchaca shits are deadly.
Yeah, they're deadly, man. Anyways, yeah, crazy.
It's just one of those.
It was
times,
just one time, though.
It's just one of those times where you kind of misread your.
It was
your
just
body.
A shark, you know. Like you said, it's like you think it's a fart, and then all of a sudden.
That's crazy how it just.
Luckily, it was just a little bit. I mean, it was just like runny.
Hey, who was it?
Did you prairie dog that? Did you prairie dog?
Well, yeah. I mean, I held it after that.
Who was it that shat on himself?
Eric.
Oh, yeah.
Eric got like, freaking hammered, and his dad had to, like, hose him off with the hose.
And we're not talking about the radical thinker, Eric.
No,
that's not my
cousin, Eric. Yeah, that was Eric.
No, that's funny, dude.
Yeah, so.
I remember him telling that story now. Yeah, my dad had to freaking wash me down, strip me naked.
Yeah, nasty.
I feel like a baby again.
Yeah. All right. So what topic was that?
That was our favorite vacations.
From favorite vacations to talking shit.
Was that the first?
That was the first topic.
All right.
Who wants to go next? Anyone?
Anybody? You have a topic, Juan?
Uh-oh. Not right now. Sorry.
What about you? You got one?
It's in the works.
I guess that leaves me.
It's being built up right now.
All right. Well, I guess I'll just start one off. You know, they say that you shouldn't talk about, you know, sex, religion, and politics, because it's normally faux pas, you know, whatever you want to call it. But I'm going to go ahead and break all the rules and talk about sex, religion, and politics.
Okay.
All right.
Okay,
so I'll start off with sex. So,
yeah,
men and women are created equal, right?
Sure.
I want to congratulate the two females that passed Ranger School.
Awesome.
You know, one of the hardest freaking schools in the military has to offer. And so, you know,
round of applause, guys. Like,
that's like, woo! You know, wow. Like, if they can do it.
That's historic, right?
Yeah, it's very historic. You know, they've never allowed females. And out of 300 or 200 and something, only like 90 people graduated and two of them were females, you know. And, you know, they got recycled a few times, but they got through. And that happens to normally. You know, that's a normal thing. Like, you get recycled through. You know, you get through it. But, I want to congratulate them. They did awesome.
Awesome.
Let me see. Like, sex, that was sex, and now we got politics and religion. I'm going to mix this one up, but I'm not going to make it about religion. So they asked Donald Trump what his favorite book is. Okay. And, you know, he wrote a book, and it's called, what's it called? The Art of the Deal or something like that. And they asked him, what's your favorite book? He goes, The Art of the Deal is my favorite book. He goes, it's my second favorite book.
The one he wrote. Okay.
He goes, the first one is the Bible. And when I started laughing, I was like, the Bible? I was like, yeah, so he said the Bible is his favorite book. Okay. And then, you know, and then his book that he wrote is his second.
He just
book.
Said that for show, dude.
So, and then I think they tried to get him to quote something out of the Bible. He couldn't come up with anything.
Oh, my God.
Something like that. I don't know. I didn't read the whole thing. But I think you already had a topic about Donald Trump.
Yeah, I did, but I don't think we really truly like dissected it well enough.
Mira, compadre, ese compa Donald Trump es puro mierda, güey.
Okay. So basically, he says
puro shit.
Full shit.
No, so, but like, Donald Trump. So I'll bring him up. Okay. This is a Hispanic panel right here, right?
Yeah.
Last time you talked to him about, was everybody Hispanic?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. As well. So, you know, speaking for Hispanics, you know, nobody really likes him in the Hispanic community. I'm pretty sure, you know, nobody does.
Of course not, man.
He's just going after, you know,
the white vote.
Well, the white vote, man. I mean, he's trying to make a splash, right? And he says Mexicans love him, so I don't know where he thinks that. So, what I want to say about him is...
Well, when
is,
you have a bunch of yes men giving you, like, fake-ass polls.
Of course.
Where it's like, oh, it's like, here's our surveys and stuff, sir. Mm-hmm. Like random, like, totally, like, like fix those numbers.
Well, first of all, let's just get real. He's not going to win the presidency. I mean, he's way too flamboyant or way too out there, I guess is the thing.
Way too extreme, let's just... I
mean, well, he's like... He's too extreme, like...
He's like... That's what it is.
He's too extreme.
Yeah, you know. He's very, very right.
And then on top of that, he wants to get rid of the people that were born here, the anchor babies. I mean, that's... How is he selling this?
That's everybody in the population, man. Because we're Hispanics. You know, we our parents come from Mexico. They immigrated over here.
Let me tell you something. And this country is great because we're a nation of immigrants.
Exactly.
All right? We're a nation of immigrants. So the moment... people start to think that they're just better than everyone else.
It's false.
You know, everyone who came here came for what reason? For a better
way. American dream.
The American dream. For a chance at something else. And all of a sudden, these guys are just now too big to think that anyone else who wants to have a dream isn't good enough to come here. I mean, that's just ridiculous. I mean... the reason why this country is great is because we have so many ideas from so many different cultures, and we all come together.
It's a melting pot.
And it's the melting pot of, like, the West, and that's why we're great. And this guy is saying that, you know, immigration is bad, and we're going to cut the borders off, and we're going to build a fence, and we're going to make Mexico pay for it, and all this craziness.
Obama just had a speech recently where he addressed the nation about immigrants, about immigration.
All right, so what did he say?
He was saying that that America is built on, like, the foundation of...
yeah, I saw the speech. It was a really good one.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it just goes back to that. I'm trying to just sort of back that up. It's like, hey, look, we're a nation of immigrants. Deal with it, you know. Stop trying to stop people from coming over. You guys keep saying that we're taking jobs and stuff, but taking jobs that people don't want.
Man, dude, there was this picture I saw. It was pretty... It hit me pretty hard, man, because it goes to show that, you know, there's lazy people out there that want it the easy way.
Oh, my gosh, yes.
And there was a guy outside on the corner saying, you know, homeless, anything to help. One of those generic signs that a homeless man makes.
Yeah.
And this guy, I think it was from Walmart, has a sign
that says,
Walmart
one.
Is hiring.
Yeah.
Like,
I saw this.
Get your ass up. Go to Walmart, and apply work. For a job, and get paid. Work for what you want, man.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's all about convenience.
It's actually kind of sad, man.
It is sad.
It's sad. It is.
Very sad.
You know, America is going to be great for many different reasons. One of them is to get your goddamn lazy ass off the goddamn couch and
there's
go
so
find
much
a job
opportunity.
And do something with you, with yourself, and go find an opportunity. I think what it boils down to, I mean.
Hey, if you're looking for a job, Solar City's hiring.
Yeah, just to let you know. And if you are looking for a job, call
contact
one of us. Me. And we'll hook you
my
up.
Phone number is 682-552-2131. Just kidding.
Just kidding. Just kidding. But try it. It's plain.
We get a bunch of phone calls at like 2 in the morning, 3 in the morning.
I'm looking for a job. Well, you could have done 682 and then that famous ass phone number with the Zay.
Oh, yeah.
That 7 digits, that was like the name of a song. Call, what was it? 8565304, something like that. I forgot his. You know that song I'm talking about?
9 5 8 6 7 5 3 0 9.
That's the one. Yeah,
yeah, that one.
Well, apparently,
yeah.
That was the actual girl's number.
Yeah, that was the her number.
That was actual girl's right. Number.
Yeah. That's crazy,
that's
man. They just blasted it all over
that, yeah.
The radio
on
and stuff.
Radio. Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. So, you know, and you know, so I guess politically speaking, America's only going to be great once we get our lazy asses start working. And I'm not talking about, I'm saying us as Americans. Okay, Americans. Mm-hmm. All right, you're an American. I'm an American. You American, right?
Fuck yeah.
You're a fucking American, right?
I'm proud to be an American.
Juan, are you an American?
Yes, sir.
All right. And you know what? The Constitution says, 14th Amendment says, if you're born here, you're goddamn American. That's the way it's going to be.
That's an amendment. You can't
ratify that and change that.
That's the stuff that I would. He's just radical, man. All the shit that he's saying. Now you got Republicans fucking jumping on there and coming up with some stupid shit. Right. Today they said that one guy said that they're gonna start tracking people like a FedEx package.
Nah.
Damn. And once they came over here and they got their visa, they would see, okay, you got 6 months. I see where you're at. Now I'm gonna ship your ass out. I mean, it's just stupid.
Yeah.
They don't know what the hell they're doing.
I know.
But what doesn't it say? What's the okay? Why okay? Somebody said, and when the last time I did the topic about Donald Trump, so he's saying that he actually is tracking well. He's got like a lot of like early lead in terms of actually being the candidate. Is that even how is that even possible? How come he hasn't been
honestly?
Like, how come he hasn't been like laughed out of the media?
Actually,
like,
the media honestly, I don't think he's winning the Republican vote. He might be winning the popular vote, but I don't think Republicans really want him. Mm. As their, you know, lead candidate.
And also, I mean, wouldn't it make more sense for Mitt Romney to run again? I mean, I'm honestly just...
Sometimes it's not the way it works. Like, if you're a loser one time, all right, if you lose one time, that's your shot. You know, you got to find somebody fresh.
Bullshit.
Okay, well, tell me who's ran again after they lost an election. Who's ran again?
Perot.
Who?
Perot.
Oh, Perot does it every time. I'm talking about an actual, independent.
And
talking about a Democrat or Republican who has ran again.
And
Bob
and,
Dole didn't run again. Dude was old. Let me see.
McCain couldn't run again. He was old.
So. What was the other guy? I have his name at the tip of my tongue.
I don't think nobody has, dude.
Quayle. Dan Quayle. He never ran again. I mean, it's kind of like... You're not gonna give money to a guy who already lost. You're gonna give money to the new guy, new face, fresh start. That's who you're gonna go.
Well, because like, wouldn't it make sense for like, just because he's already had a media attention. He's already had the national spotlight on him once before. So you can already, you know, sell to the American people. Like, okay,
No, I don't think that.
And that's, I mean, I've seen the debates. He's he gave Obama a run for his money because the media didn't even know he was.
Obama was the one though.
I was going to say, the media didn't know he was going to be as smart as he was, but whatever. I figured as much as he was, as far as Republican guns, he's very rational.
Yeah.
I figured.
And you know what? And we also need to talk about something else, man. So I think it was today or yesterday, they gunned down this cop in Houston. Is it Houston?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Just cold blood, man, in a gas station. A gas station's all over the news. And I just want to say how pathetic that shit is. They ambushed this guy, you know, and they killed him. Like these guys. I mean,
what kind of guys?
Criminals.
I think it was just one guy.
Oh, I thought it was only one. Okay. So this guy just goes up to him and just shoots him because he's a cop. Yeah. Basically, that's what it boils down to. So
what was his ethnicity?
I don't know. I don't want to speculate. I think he was black though. That's fine.
He was.
I know you're
I'm just playing. I don't know, man. I don't know. It could have been, the white guys, they're kind of crazy. They might have been a white dude. Cause they'd be crazy.
Yeah, like dude.
You know, could have been a Mexican guy.
No, he was a black dude.
It might have been an illegal immigrant.
Yeah.
Oh, he was black?
Uh-huh.
See, I didn't even know that.
Right. Yeah, man.
That's crazy, man.
So that
you seen that video for the reporter? That got shot.
Oh, there's another reporter. That reporter that we just doing.
So the reporter that went crazy. He killed his old colleagues. Two of the cameraman and the lady.
They were a couple. They were dating, man.
They were dating.
They were dating. Yeah.
Wow. Not each other.
Yeah, they were.
No, the guy. The
I heard the article said there were a couple.
No, the camera guy was dating a producer that was about to go to like some other big market.
Oh.
And then the lady had a fiance. They just moved in together.
And if you read his manifesto, it's crazy. Like, I mean,
he shot himself,
stuff.
Right?
Yeah, he killed himself. But man, that was crazy.
Did you see the video with the first person?
No, I hadn't seen any of
it. He recorded while
dude,
he shot.
He had his gun.
Oh, he was recording
like
while
this.
He was
he had a GoPro, dude, and he saw.
Oh yeah, that's right.
The gun, and the, nobody even saw it, dude. The girl that was interviewing the lady didn't even see it
because they were.
And
yeah.
He, you know, he brought it back in, and then a few seconds later, just.
Just started
that
shooting
that reporter,
and it was
got
shot, and, it went
and
viral.
She was still
it
running.
Went uploaded and it went viral.
I don't like to look at that kind of stuff. To be
I was
honest
like,
with
damn.
You, I know there's videos out there. They said it, but I don't like to watch that kind of stuff. I mean, I've seen enough shit in my life to I don't care to see it again. So you know why watch it? I know it happened. You know everybody says, oh, there's a video. You know, and I don't like to watch that stuff. To be honest with you, but still, I just want to bring it up because I mean, we got people shooting cops. You know, we got. Crazy reporters, gay black guys going crazy because the guy was black and gay and supposedly they were racist against him and they, you know, they fucked him somehow at work and that's why he kind of went crazy. Also the shootings at a church, something like that. God. So, I mean, I, it was just, I don't know,
everything's
crazy. It was kind of crazy.
Had,
so
you had sex, religion, race,
I mean,
and damn.
Yeah,
like,
you got everything
covered.
In there,
you
know. You
had everything.
And, but you know what it boils down to is this. All right. All right. I see a few things wrong. First, some places, they trying to take away the Pledge of Allegiance, right?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, and you got that. And then they got rid of religion out of school. That was another thing. Then they try to get rid of In God We Trust.
Out of the money.
Away. I mean, they're trying to get rid of all these kind of things. What makes people love America? You know, they're trying to get rid of that stuff. Because I was indoctrinated when I was in kindergarten. They used to
you say
the
Pledge
of Allegiance.
Allegiance.
You're like, I don't even know what the hell I'm saying, but I'm saying it, and I'm looking at the flag, and I'm like, wow, this is like, you know, one nation.
Under God.
Indivisible, with liberty and justice for all, or whatever. You know, whatever the case may be.
Turn into a nation of pussies.
Basically. So, you know, everybody's offended. Everybody gets offended about
yeah,
everything.
Dude, that's what gets me, dude.
Why does everybody offended about everything? Is it social media? Is it now that everybody could just be opinionated?
Yeah, everybody's a commentator. That's you what know, it is. Everybody can blast everything to the world.
Well, I was getting that with all the social media and people's opinions. You know what? If somebody wants to beat their kids because they're being bad, let them. You know, you want to teach kids how to be respectful and how to be, you know, respectful to their elders, be respectful for it. If you're going to babies all the time and not teach them respect, they're just going to run like crazy. They're going to run wild like crazy. You know, you're going to have like Ricky Bobby kids, you know, walking all over their parents and grandparents. It's
fuck
just,
you, Dad.
Yeah.
I mean, I think disciplining their kids, not beat their kids.
I meant discipline. You know, I say beat the kids because I was beat. My dad beat the crap out of me, but he didn't abuse me.
Big ass belt.
You know, he got a belt. He beat us. Or whatever you call it. I say beat, but he just
whipped.
Spanked us.
He whipped us.
He whipped us.
Whipped.
You know?
Whipped.
I mean, I'm not talking about like putting kids in hospitals, putting bruises on their faces and cutting them. I'm not talking about all that.
But well, they can't see it, dog.
What do you call it? No, what is it? It was it's like you can hit them but never take away their dignity or something like that. That's what someone
yeah.
would say.
True.
But you know, but that's basically code for you can hit them, but just don't leave a mark. Basically.
Yeah, I mean,
leave them with their dignity.
It's just
a nice way of saying it, basically.
Yeah, and you know what? We're putting it mildly, but people are just getting too offended. You know, mind your own damn business, man. You know, and just raise your kids right.
Be civilized.
Be civilized. Teach your kids to go to school. You know, people who come up in and we're gonna have those people that come up from poor areas, you know. Poor areas that they're in a bad situation they can never get out of. But you know what I say, get off your lazy ass and go out there and do something. That's all I got to say. And the reason why is because, yeah, I used to think I was a Democrat. But I'm actually more Republican than anything. You know, I don't believe in social programs anymore. I used to. There's good in it and there's bad in it, you know. There's this meme where the government posted a warning for some kind of woodpecker or some kind of bird, and they said, "Do not feed the birds because they will not be able to learn and fend for themselves and learn how to feed themselves." And then the government like has welfare like up the ass, and so they made it like, "Oh, so the government believes these feeding these birds." Is a bad idea because they won't learn from fend themselves, but they'll have like welfare for all these people who want to get welfare and not do anything.
Which is kind of sort of true.
It's like a double standard.
But then people, you always hear those stories about people that, I think, you know, do play the system.
I think those, well, there's a lot of people. We know a lot of people who play this.
We do. Yeah. Personally. Hey,
if you want to buy, grocery, dog, I know a lady that sells her, her food stamps, dog.
Exactly. Damn.
She gets like $300 full of food stamps.
Yeah. You just pay her $100.
Pay $100 for a dog, and you're good.
Mm-hmm. It's exactly.
It's tough. I mean, you know, I think what we're really missing is leaders. I think we're missing, you know, people that'll. You talk about. You talk about, you know, the poor people being lazy and this and that. If you grow up in a poor community, you grow up and all you see is nobody doing anything. All right. You see is drug dealing. All you see is gang banging.
And I grew up in that.
All you see is violence. Me too. Yeah. And that's all you see. That's what becomes your world.
Exactly.
There's people that don't leave five blocks of their neighborhood, their whole young childhood. And they don't see what's out there.
Exactly.
You know, and you ain't got nobody that's going in there to try to help out these kids, to show them that, you know what, there is progress, there is life outside these, you know, this hood that you think it is.
But the role models are Eminem, Dr. Dre,
NWA. And that's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying, that we have that lack of leaders that are going into these communities and helping people out to bring them out and show them, you know, this is what you do.
But how many people would actually practice that once they get shown that?
But you know who I had, though.
You have somebody.
But you know who I had. I had my mom and dad. Yeah. They're the ones who told me, don't get into that shit. And I didn't. You know what I mean?
Yeah, they push you to do better for yourself. I mean
my mom would beat my ass if I brought a 70 home.
Yeah, I remember that.
Louis, do you remember that shit?
Yeah, all the time whenever my dad ripped out Carlos' tongue piercing
from his tongue. Yeah, from his tongue.
Out of his, like, just straight up.
Yeah, because my brother wanted to do something stupid. But, I mean, my only role model was my
parents.
I couldn't
wear JNCOs.
Yeah, exactly. We could not wear any stupid gangster-looking rap shit or any kind of breakdancing stuff.
I was so mad.
Your parents didn't want you to represent them like
exactly.
that.
Exactly, they didn't want to. But you're right. The role models, man, and leadership, that's something that, you know, that we don't have sometimes, and people look up to the wrong people, and our kids look up to the wrong people, you know? Mm-hmm. And so, I don't know, I think there needs to be, we're shifting our thoughts to, oh, I'm a fucking sensitive pussy, sissy lala, and your opinion offends me, so shut the fuck up, I don't want to hear that shit. We're shifting over to that, like America is. They're like, oh, I'm offended, don't say that. I'm a liberal, or whatever the case may be.
See episode 24. No, I'm just. I'm sorry. I don't mean it. I don't really mean it.
You're offending your friends, right? All right. So everybody.
You're talking about them without even knowing about.
Well, I don't even know. Yeah, but the thing is, I'm trying to say, look.
That's exactly how they are. They basically tell everybody that offends them, shut the fuck up. That's
right.
Whatever
it is, I'm just saying, look, stop being sensitive, you know, you know, I'm sorry if I offend you, but, and I'm sorry if I've said things that offend you.
Don't say sorry.
But guess what?
Pussy.
That's the reality. That is the reality. That's the reality of the situation here, is that we're going down the drain because people want to have an opinion. Everybody has an opinion. Just respect their opinion.
The thing is, when I was going to say, going back to the whole the social media aspect, is like everybody has an audience. Everybody has like at least 100 Facebook friends. You know, everyone has, you know, all these followers and stuff like that. And so it's like giving a microphone.
Right?
Look,
if you guys want to look into somebody, look into this guy. His name is Dr. Ben Carson, and that guy is one smart dude.
I bought his books.
Man, he is an awesome guy.
Man, he is really. I watched his movie, Gifted Hands, and I read the book first.
I hadn't even seen the movie.
That book is great. Man, the movie's great. But
every time I see his freaking, like, him talk, it's like, wow, this guy is so freaking smart.
He's really professional. He's really, really smart.
Professional. I mean, everything. I mean, it's just like, I'm in love with this guy, you know? And for those of you who don't know who he is, he's a black, like, heart surgeon or something like
he's
that.
He's a neurosurgeon, yeah.
Neurosurgeon, there you go. I mean, so smart. Smart guy, man.
He changed the game, dog.
And he, when I see him, I'm like, man, this guy needs to run for president. I think he is running for president, right? Yeah. Man, I mean, and he's a Republican, and I don't care. I mean, this guy's a really smart
guy. He's really smart guy. Mm-hmm. Really, really smart guy.
Well, damn, I mean, why don't they just at the Republican National Convention, just get him.
Honestly, I think the Republicans are going to choose this guy, to be honest with you.
Oh, for sure, man. I think he's a well-rounded guy.
Yeah.
Very well-rounded guy.
I mean, he impresses me. I only seen him talk a few times, and I'm like, whoa. This is the guy I want to vote for.
He's impressive. Do you think that when it comes to the Democratic, who will get the Democratic
vote? I don't care about the Democratic side anymore. I mean,
I was gonna ask you, do you
Hillary
think
ain't gonna win?
Hillary or Bernie Sanders?
No, that doesn't matter.
Oh, damn.
They're not gonna win. History shows that the Republicans gonna win this election. So
yeah, they
pretty much swap.
Yeah, they swap after. Yeah.
Yeah, after a few, like a couple of elections.
Yeah.
Yep. It's time to start a new war. we already pretty much started a new war. We're going back to Iraq, so I mean, it doesn't matter.
You can like start gearing up,
sure,
start suiting up again.
Oh yeah,
yeah. Maybe you can become a. What's the next thing above lieutenant? Captain?
Well, I'm a captain already.
What? No. Since when? Why the hell did I not know you're a captain?
Since June 16th of this year, I've been a captain.
I found out like a long time.
Did you put
ago,
it? Did you put it on Facebook?
No, I don't put that kind of shit on my Facebook.
Damn.
I don't put professional stuff on Facebook. That's just for like,
let alone YouTube.
Funny videos and stuff for me and like, you know, whatever. But look. What's my rank on there?
Oh, captain.
There you go. Damn. As of June 16th.
Shit.
There
you go. Like a boss. I should just give you, just take off the shirt and give it to you right now. Just look.
Kinda am a boss. I'm kinda like a big deal.
Yeah.
All right. Anyways.
You got a what do you call it? It's a captain is where you basically you have, because I remember like when you were deploying, you had like a like this like little square, and then the captain would have all these like squares and shit. Like
you mean like all the platoons?
Platoons, yeah. I don't know anything.
Kinda.
I'm sorry.
Anyway, so yeah, that's that's my little diatribe, or that's my little rant about America.
Well, like
down the toilet.
One of my favorite scenes in like in the pilot episode of the newsroom, where the person, the college student, asks Jeff Daniels' character what makes America so great, and then he would go off on the like 5-minute rant about why America isn't so great. And then that was you didn't see it.
No,
see
I haven't seen it, but okay. I'll check it out.
Yeah, it's like
a
it's
new
like,
show, right?
No, the newsroom is long. I think it's
a long time.
Long time ago. It's,
oh, okay.
It's really.
I
old.
Saw the preview for.
It was with Jeff Daniels.
One of the seasons.
Jeff Daniels, the guy from Slumdog Millionaire and a bunch of other people, right. A lot of actors.
What guy?
Dev Patel.
Dave Patel?
Oh, really?
Yeah, he's
I didn't
in
know
it.
He was in it.
He's in it. Yeah, a lot of people. And also that hot chick. Her name is, she was in that one Ryan Reynolds movie where they swap bodies with Jason Bateman. And she's going to be in X-Men Apocalypse as Psylocke.
Oh, the girlfriend.
Olivia Munn.
Olivia Munn.
Wilde? No.
Olivia Wilde.
I think it is Olivia Munn, though. Whatever. Anyways, she's in it.
Oh, it might be Munn.
Google it.
I'll Google it right now.
Go for it.
I thought it was Olivia Wilde.
Oh, Olivia Wilde was in Tron.
Oh, yeah. Man, Tron is such a great
Tron
movie.
Legacy?
I love that movie. Dude.
I had a topic, Louis.
All right, Juan,
and
go for it.
The other, I seen that you had this, so I'm sorry if I'm... I don't know.
So you've seen the in the thumbnails.
I think I think it was a topic, but
okay.
I just want to, you know, give my opinion.
All
right. Where the hell, you know, he's talking about America, right? Where the hell's our limit gonna be, right? You know, I just don't understand you, right? We got, you know, I have my own opinion about a lot of stuff, but you know, growing up, I had a mom and dad, right?
Yeah.
And you know, dated girls, right? Got married to my wife, right? Yeah, a man and a woman, right? And then things started changing to, you know, to gays, right?
Oh, yeah, yeah,
so
that's right.
The whole gay movement came, all that happened,
you
right?
You got it.
So then we had this Jenner, whatever his name is.
Oh, Jenner, yeah.
Yeah. So
the transgender thing, we did the Bruce Jenner.
Okay, so you
Caitlyn Jenner.
So you got that whole thing, right? Transgender. Oh, what's next? Because this ain't going to stop right there.
Because it used to be the LG... LGB community, like
okay, hold on, wait.
LGBT.
You know what? I'm glad you brought that up.
And then it changes. It keeps adding.
I'm glad you brought that up. But you know what? The other, I would say 2 days ago, there was a headline with Miley Cyrus, and she's a pansexual. What the hell is a pansexual?
I don't know what that is.
What the hell is a pansexual?
I don't know, dude.
I read it. It says she's now a pansexual, and like I didn't even run. First of all, I didn't want to read the article because there's Miley Cyrus in it, but the headline was Miley Cyrus is a pansexual. I'm like,
I'm a hunter sexual.
What?
I'm a hunter sexual.
What the hell is that?
Hunter sexual.
I love to hunt.
That's more like a hunter file or something.
Hunter file.
Hunter file.
Love to hunt.
You love to hunt.
What, what is a pansexual?
I have no idea, but I'll look it up after I look up this movie.
I mean, we did a topic. We did a topic in the last podcast about hashtag free the nipple, and then that's one of the things that Miley Cyrus supports.
Free the nipple.
Yeah, just to free the nipple.
So we're gonna start like marrying our dogs or.
Bestiality.
Yeah, bestiality. Or we're gonna objects. You know, a guy falls in love with his lamp, or you know, I don't know.
Wasn't there like a story that where somebody fell in love with their car or something like that? I don't remember. Or that, I don't know.
No, what's his name? Joaquin Phoenix did her. Didn't he fall in love with his computer?
Yeah,
computer,
her.
Something like that.
Computer chick. But she ended up coming out to be real.
What?
In the movie.
Really?
I haven't seen the movie.
I've only seen the first half of the movie.
Yeah, I think she comes out to be real.
Damn.
He believed in it so much, dog.
And she was so smart that she manifested herself into some kind of body.
Joaquin, I'm going to make myself for you. Watch this. I don't know how it went out, but I think she came out real.
And was it Scarlett Johansson? That would be funny if it actually was.
Yeah, it was Respucia.
Respucia. Shit.
Okay, so we got Olivia Wilde.
Yeah.
She was in it.
I guess that was
it. Is that her?
Yeah, that's her.
See, it's Olivia Wilde.
Hell.
You remember Olivia Wilde?
Let me see this. Make sure my girlfriend doesn't hear me.
She's not paying attention. You're good.
Hey, a pansexual is not limited in sexual choice with regard to biological sex, gender, or gender identity.
What the hell is that? Wait, say that, read it again?
So it's basically like a bisexual.
Not limited in sexual choice with regard to biological sex, gender, or gender identity.
So
she could date like a transsexual?
Yeah, basically. She's bisexual plus she can date a transsexual.
So she can date like a girl who transforms herself into a guy?
Yeah.
And she wouldn't care?
Exactly.
I don't know if there's a such thing.
There is a such thing.
Really?
Yeah.
A pansexual?
Pansexual, right? You just named it. Wow. So that's what that means. Anyways, crazy. All right. So go on, Juan. What else were you?
I mean, that was it. I mean, I don't know.
So what else is next? Okay.
I mean, haven't we already reached that limit?
I'm sure there's gonna be more extremes than just that, man.
What if people start falling in love with inanimate objects? Like, I love this beer. This is my beer. Yeah. This will always be a beer. Or my phone.
Then that'll just be like an idol, though, man. You know,
people in love with their cars. Right. Yeah.
Like the fuel tank, you know,
the fuel tank. Like, you know, squirt, squirt, squirt. Jizz, skeet, skeet. So, for those of you who can't hear what's going on,
someone off camera is saying about someone falls in love with a car.
Yeah.
That's stupid.
It was a 60 minute special on that. I'm just kidding. I could have been 60 minutes for all I know.
And then they were doing an oil change. Awesome.
It's all perfectly lubricated. It's all lube. Perfectly legal.
It was the best lube job ever.
All right.
He put his dipstick to check.
Dipstick all the way
in. I don't see it going any further than that. I honestly don't.
I'm sure there's been more extremes.
Whoa, what do you call a person who's in love with aliens?
We can't.
I mean, it can go deeper. I mean, what if you fall in love with an angel?
Because like,
wait
I
a minute, I already
it.
Did.
I can see like,
woo.
The societal norms is going to dictate, you know, what happens. Like the way we've come to this point of is because it's become a societal norm. After when people start saying that, you know, they fall in love with their phones or their cars or whatever.
Wait, hold on, it becomes
a thing where it's not a norm.
Before anything, you might want to remember that he said that. You want to cut that out?
Oh, okay. Yeah.
I'll cut that out.
Yeah.
I have a right to voice my. Yeah.
Can't shoot this. Hey, what were we talking about earlier?
Please don't unsubscribe.
Oversensitive ass motherfuckers.
Whoa.
I don't have a notepad. I'm not going to censor anything. I was like, whatever. Everything will make it to air. It's fine.
Hey,
all right.
Tell
cool.
them
it's
to
fine. It's fine.
Eat shit and die.
No, he can't do it.
No, man. I mean,
I just lost
like,
more sponsors.
Like, Whatever.
Edit it out, man. You can keep this in the you know, archives.
In the archives?
Yeah. Keep it in the archives.
Yeah.
You went to Girls Gone Wine?
I did, girl.
So tell us about your Girls Gone Wine. You know, what the spices that
you
saw.
Oh, man, that's some pretty cool spices. Like, really? If you want to marinate some chicken,
right?
They have chicken shit spices.
Chicken shit.
And we want to marinate like some steaks, beef, you know? They have cow shit spices.
Really?
Yeah, dude, it's pretty funny. Like, horse shit spices.
Oh, shit. Bullshit.
Oh, no. If you want to eat horse shit.
Horse shit. It's crazy. It's funny, dude.
Girls Gone Wine.
I wanted to get some, but it was $7 for a freaking little shaker of freaking spices. I'm like, nah. Go to get the great value kind.
All right. Okay. All right. So we want to go to the next topic?
Yeah. Isai?
Last topic.
Isai, finish us out.
Sure, dude. I guess. I don't really have a topic.
Well, let's just talk about whatever. Whatever comes to mind.
Hey,
we've already done that topic.
Zip it.
He said zip it.
Just playing.
No, I mean like.
Just playing. I didn't say that. He said it.
I'm just reiterating.
The last time we did, I mean, there was one podcast that I did, you know, check it out. That way I didn't have any topics. We just talked about whatever, and we just
let the conversation, whatever we were thinking at the time.
So let the conversation go wherever it's gonna go. Just
yeah.
I want to talk about.
Let's talk about sex,
baby. You already talked about that.
Yeah, you're right.
Nah, but I don't know. I guess I want to talk about what's going to power the United States of America in the future. You know, energy.
Renewable energy.
Wasn't that like a thing that was supposed to happen by now?
It's happening now, slowly but surely, man.
Isn't it too slow?
Yeah, well, there's powers slow. That are trying to fight against it.
Yeah, I know.
That's the thing.
You know, that's what it is. It's just people that have money who don't want to.
I bet you if big oil didn't fight against it, we'd already.
It's an energy war, exactly. Dude.
It's an energy war starting. You know, we're starting a fucking war here.
Yeah, we are.
You know, the old companies, they don't want renewable energy. They're like, what the hell? Like, we want to burn fucking fossil fuels, and that's what we want to do. I mean, we're like, why? Yeah. We got a better way. Let's just switch over to that right now.
We already have, you know, wind turbines
yeah.
that produce energy. How much do they produce?
And there are solar panels.
Solar panels is another way from the sun.
And then you can get companies like Solar City like doing their part.
Yeah, we're going to have them sponsor you, so just for saying that. You just got 100,000 subscribers, Louis.
Look, let me tell you something. The idea of having electricity at everybody's house and like localized was actually an old, idea from the beginning and inception of electricians.
What is she talking about? What's she talking about, Juan?
She wants to go gambling.
Oh.
Okay. You want to roll the dice? No dice, Chino.
Has it already been an hour? No, it has not.
No, it has not.
We've been rolling for 55 minutes.
55 minutes there, buddy. 55 minutes. Anyways, so renewable energy, they just found out that batteries weren't like efficient at the time, and it's understandable. But it is now; it's like efficient enough to run a whole house. But the thing is, it's just not cost effective anymore. I mean, we have like the old lines that are there, and people want electricity at all times of the day. So you know that's just the way it works. I mean, people are gonna fight against it all the time. The energy companies, anyways, they don't want to change their model,
right? Because with the whole that paradigm shift would just lose the money, so they wouldn't want that. So. And it's only whenever the money runs out, then they'll allow it.
You mean when they run out of fossil fuels?
I should do more research on it, but like, isn't there like solar highways or something like that?
There is.
Kind of like in the movie.
You replace all the highways with the solar highway project that they want to do, which costs trillions of dollars. You power all the electricity in the United States.
That'd be crazy, dude.
so much. But anyways, everybody's waiting for us.
Our audience is bored.
Our audience is just like telling us to wrap that shit up. No, like,
let's
Let's
talk about the casinos.
And how much does anybody have any good gambling stories? Like they were they just bet big and just won?
Yeah, like I went. I'll just tell mine. I went to Vegas, and Pati, my mom, and my dad were getting ready to come downstairs. I said, you know what? I had the bug inside me. I wanted to go gamble. Uh-huh. I said, all right, I'm ready to go. Go ahead and get ready. I'm gonna be downstairs at the craps table.
You had a bug and you wanted to go gamble? Oh my gosh!
So, you know, so I went down there. So I went down there, uh-huh. And in like 40 minutes, I waited 40 minutes before they actually went downstairs. But in 40 minutes, I won $500 on the craps table.
40 minutes, $500.
So the three guys on the side of me, they rolled, but they kept hitting their numbers. Each one hit their numbers like 3 or 4 times, and it came to me. And it was one of the only times that I hit my number like 6 times.
The table was hot.
I mean, we were hot. I hit my number 6 times.
I remember that.
They put all the pressure on me like, oh, man.
You better not.
You know, don't fuck this up, man. We got a roll going. And I hit my number 6 times. And I got them fast, too. So I kept putting money down. And when I walked away with 5 black chips and like a few more chips.
That's cool, dude.
Yeah. And I was like, oh, no. Oh, no. Wait, hold on. It was 5 black chips. They wanted to give me a $500. They wanted to give me a $500 chip, but I stayed with the black chips.
So I can lose that one real quick.
Yeah. So what I did was I used only 1 black chip every day that we were there till I gambled with.
And you lost it all.
I ended up losing most of it. Yeah.
Damn. Yeah. You just stopped gambling?
No. I've won on the craps table before, but
I invested $40 in your brother.
My brother.
Carlo. And we were in Vegas. For training.
30 minutes yoga?
In 30 minutes, we got like $200.
Yeah.
From 40 bucks.
Did y'all walk away with it?
We walked away. We had to go to sleep, wake up early the next day. And then 2 days passed, the next day, we go back down. We lose it all.
Oh, my God.
Damn.
We lost $200, dude. And we ended up going to the strip to go gamble some more. And I got us up to about another $120.
Are you serious?
But I kept playing, dude, and next thing you know, I freaking lost that too. Blackjack.
Shit. Is there anything, the thing about
it's always up and down, man.
The thing about
funny gambling stories.
The thing about gambling is
more
that,
like loser stories.
Yeah, loser stories.
What?
Annabelle on a slot machine. $75. Right,
Annabelle puts in $5, and it didn't come out.
No.
She didn't even know she was okay.
Here, let me.
This thing ate my money.
All right. Just not on camera, but just tell the story.
Okay, we went to Windstar. Not sure how long ago. How was it? 2 weeks ago. Then I didn't know what I was doing. I never played any slot machines or any penny machines. But so I was interested in playing on a slot machine. So when I put in a slot machine, I put $5. And then when I started playing, I just pushed a button, like pushing and pushing. I guess I wanted to bet more, like 2 more. And then I was like, what am I doing? I don't understand this. So I clicked on a button that says help. Maybe.
Help.
I clicked on this button and it said help. Maybe they'll teach me. Maybe it ain't my money. I don't know. This thing don't work. Me and I told Omar, that's why there's nobody playing in this area. And so, anyways, the lady came and then I told her, ma'am, I think this thing ate my $5. And then she goes, okay, let me go check it out. So she puts her codes or whatever. Then she's like, well, you actually lost the $5. And I did? You bet it. You bet $2 more, $2 something. And then I'm like, oh, well, I'm not playing this machine no more. That's why nobody plays here. It just eats up the money. No. So when she, and then I asked her, how do you play this slot machine? So I can maybe next time I'll learn how to do it. So she was telling me all these things. And in my mind, I'm like, I don't know what the heck she's saying. I'm not playing this thing. So then I went off, and then I'm like, this Windstar is not for me. Then afterwards,
$5.
I started going to the penny machine, and I was winning on the doggy machine. So, yeah. Yeah. Wow. No more.
Moral of the story is that the slot machine ate her $5.
The moral of the story is nobody understands slot machines. Like, you know, there's like no like real.
I think only like 10% of people win.
Real way of like, because like knowing the combination.
And you see those pictures on the walls in the casinos where people won like thousands of dollars.
Well, my dad,
how true is that?
Dad, oh, my dad true. Won like
they should hand out certificates of like I lost $100.
Yeah. Dad won $300 at the slot machine.
Man,
in
my
Vegas.
Dad always freaking wins. He's got so much freaking
luck
when it comes to slot machines.
Yeah, I was betting. You know how you bet? You know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 coins or whatever, yeah. Whatever it is, right? It was like 25 cents, and I was playing. And I started playing. I was like 50 cent, and I was winning. And I said, "Fuck it," I would start playing max. So I bet the five. So I was betting $1.25 every single time. And you know, depending how many coins you bet, that's how much you're gonna win. So I'm betting. I'm winning. And when I was betting the max, I was winning. All of a sudden, I started just losing money. Right. I'm down to my last two coins. So I'm like, fuck it. I couldn't bet my max. So I hit the two. I get jackpots. All seven. The sevens were all on fire. Oh. It was $36,000, and I only bet two coins because that's all I had.
Oh.
And I was like,
you lost your
I was
shit.
Like, look at that.
If you would have like, bet max. Max, you would have won the jackpot.
Yeah.
So what'd you win?
Nothing. I didn't win shit. Because I didn't have I didn't bet the max.
Whoa. Oh, that was must be so
didn't
crushing.
Didn't they give you like 100 coins or something?
Nothing.
That's what? Gay, dude. Yeah. Nah, that's really gay. That sucks, dude.
Well.
I don't piss. That's
nah. Well, I mean, yeah, no, that was that's crazy. Well, anyway, so
that's
well,
pretty that, cool, dude.
So speaking of casinos, I think people no, like, want to go to the casinos.
We're gonna go to the. You
well,
know,
I was gonna say before we go into that though, I was gonna say like, there's two stories I want to bring up. One, all both right. of them involving you. But okay. The first story, I wasn't even part of it. I was you told me that after the fact.
Okay.
Was the time when we were on the cruise.
All right.
And then you and Carlo were gambling that night away, and y'all were everything was on fire. Everyone was winning, but the thing is, it's a week long cruise, so everyone's still there and they're not going anywhere.
Right.
So you come back and gamble the next day,
and we lose
and throughout
it all.
The whole week, y'all lose everything.
So the first night we were winning. I
mean, winning.
I won like 120. I think Carlo won 160, and we started off with like I don't know, like $20 or something like that. So we were up. We're like loving it, and. Actually, I was learning how to throw craps, like in play craps.
Mm-hmm.
And, yeah, we were winning, and I thought, man, this is one of the best games ever. And then, like, my brother got, like, I don't know, 160, maybe even 180. I can't remember, but I only had, like, $120 that I won. But, like, the next day, I just lost it. Like, I lost the whole $120 thinking that, oh, you know, I could start with $20, you know, do the same thing I did the day before. Hell no, man. Then I put another $20. Then another $20. Before I knew it, I didn't have any of the money. So it kind of happens
that
way
how
sometimes.
That's works, dude. Mm-hmm. You like get so mad, you try to redeem yourself.
Like, you try to go, you try to put another exactly. in. It's like, maybe this time I'll win. Like, you think that, it's like the thing was like, all right, I've been losing so many times, I got to win in this next one.
Exactly. That's mm-hmm. exactly. But I've definitely taken more money than I've lost. If I put it all together, I've won a lot of money on the craps table.
And then the other story is basically whenever it involves me, because every time I'm like your kryptonite. I am your bad luck. Before you even say that, I'm just gonna say that's it. I don't gamble because every time I gamble I lose. Yeah. Like I am not
this guy.
I am just the worst gambler you ever want with you.
This like, is what that. If you ever see
well,
the movie,
curse, first off, watch, don't even call yourself a gambler because you don't gamble.
Yeah, you don't gamble.
But no, but I've gambled.
Have you ever seen the movie with
Vegas before?
You ever seen the movie with William H. Macy? Called the cooler.
Uh-huh.
He's the guy that they send to a table to cool off a table because he's just bad luck. And they pay him for that. They pay him for that. That's who you
just
are.
Just to cool.
Oh man. Oh god.
And so the thing is,
if my brother says play the field, and I'm like,
don't play the field
because it's the opposite of what he says.
And then every time I say play the field and you don't play the field, you go against me. It was the field.
And it's like if he tells me, oh, play the field, and I play the field, I lose. It's like.
No matter what it is, no matter what decision,
or whatever it is,
no matter what decision Juan makes based off of what I say, it's always
the opposite.
It's always the opposite. Play and play whatever you want to do, dude.
Yeah, I mean,
and then sometimes, and then one time he says,
"You know what? I'm gonna play the field, and I'm not gonna play the field." I mean, it's not.
And then one time it was like, "This is one that happened." This most hilarious role happened was where I said. Juan said, I'm going to do something. I'm going to do this. And then as the dice was right about to be rolled, I said, yeah, go ahead and do that. And he was sure. Like, fuck.
And he was lost.
Like, he lost his shit when I said that.
I said, and then it was crapped out.
Dang. That's
I mean, literally. So I, and I told him so many times, that,
don't
dude,
say anything.
Don't say anything.
Don't say
In fact,
anything.
Just stand over there. Hey, I don't even want you near
did
me.
Did you pay him back?
Hell no. No, right?
Hell no.
No, but one time I was rolling and I told you to shut up. You actually won a lot of money. I remember one time we did. I was like, dude, don't say anything. Don't I'm say just going to roll. We were rolling and you won with my dad's money. I remember.
That's right.
You were playing with my dad's money.
Yeah, that's right. I lost all that money. And so what happened was.
Took a loan out from my dad.
My dad was winning so much money that he do that smart strategy where you take the siphon the money out of your.
Out of your winnings.
And put it in your pocket. Yeah. And so instead of putting it in his pocket, because he just gave it to me instead, to me to hold on to it.
He took like a $25 chip.
No. It was. I took $50 chip.
$50.
So, and so what I was like, I had all these chips in chance. I took one of the chips out of my pocket. It was my dad's money. And I put it in there too with him, because what happened was it was the final roll. Everyone all at the table agreed, we're not gonna roll anymore. That's it. We're done. We're calling it a night. And then for the final roll, we're all gonna play the field.
Yeah, we're all gonna play the field.
And then it was because the dealer was
about to switch out.
Whoever wins that runs the table.
Like, yeah, he runs the table.
Okay, so that person was like, okay, we're gonna switch out, but here, the dealer told us, like, y'all should play the field. Like, the dealer suggested to all of us, hey, let's all play the field. It was like, the dealer was like saying, like, hey, I have a good feeling about this.
Yeah.
And so everybody on the table, including myself, I took a loan out. We all played the field. And then it was a double.
It was a
double sixes.
A double, yeah.
And then we got double. All true. Like, big,
we all got like big,
big money.
Yeah. And he got $75 and paid my dad back. No, so it was $25 because you got $75.
I remember being a 50 because I got 100 out of it. And so what I did was
But it was a triple though. You got three times the amount.
I don't know. But all I remember was I was able to pay.
They shorted your ass.
It was whatever I was.
But my dad. But he paid my dad. Goes, here, Dad. Here's the money I borrowed, and he wanted to keep all the money.
And I know I did keep the money. Yeah, I won. I kept the winnings. And so what I did was I basically used the winnings to negate some of my losings, because I already lost all the money. I had like lost hundreds of dollars, and so basically it kind of like cushioned that blow a little bit.
Yeah,
I still was negative for the whole trip, or gambling wise, anyways.
Yeah. That's cool though, man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well,
ladies and gentlemen, that has been the Musing with Menchaca show. So every week we do a podcast Monday through Friday, topic by topic. We're friends and family gather around these microphones for random topics of discussion for your amusement. So if you like the video, give us a thumbs up, share us with your friends, subscribe for more content. And you can follow me on Twitter at Chocolaki88 and comment below with any suggestions for topics, reactions to anything that's said, or feedback for the show. And you can also email me boomchocolaka4@gmail.com for anything long form you want to address on the show. And remember, you can download me this MP3 version of the show here on iTunes. Link is in the description below. And thank you very much, Juan, Isai, and Juan.
Thank you, Louis.
Thanks, Julie.
And if I offended anybody, I'm sorry. Anyways, have a good day.
I'm your host.
Also, I created a GoFund account for me because I don't want to work anymore. So if you can support that, that'd be great. Thank you.
I am your host, Louis, signing out.